welcome to the lecture number 1 of the fundamentals of machine design. As we have seen in the introduction lecture that the fundamental of machine design subject is shattered into the 3 different topics. And we are going to start with the first topic, that is the concept of the strength of material. So in this lecture, we are going to introduce you to part 1 of the concept of the strength of material. And we will start with the loads, because the stresses and each and every concept are starting with the load. Because of the application of load, we are going to calculate the stresses and its effects. That's why, let's define the load first and then different topics of related to that. So load is nothing but any external force or a moment applied on the body under its functionality. Whenever you say that the body is subjected to different kinds of a load or different kinds of the forces or any moment under its function is known as that load. Okay, so if you want to take an example, then take an example of a wheelchair, where a person is sitting on a wheelchair and the function of the wheelchair is to carry that person from one spot to another spot. So the function of the wheelchair is to carry a person. And during this functionality, the load which is applied on the body is the weight of the person. And that's why the weight of the person is known as a load. So this type of loads are going to be introduced in the further video of this lecture. And this load is going to be the key factor for the calculation of the stresses and their effects. So there are different types of the load available, and based on which different stresses are categorized. So you need to identify which type of a load is applied in our working condition. And that's why the types of the load is another important question which can be asked in your examination. So loads can be categorized by the 3 different methods. So first method is based on time. The second method is based on application. And the third method is based on area. So the load which are categorized based on time are basically 2 types. The first one is static load and the second one is dynamic load. As you all know, the name itself indicates that the static loads are basically the steady types of a load, which are steady with respect to the time. So whenever we say that the magnitude, the load is steady, then its magnitude and direction both are steady. If we can say that the magnitude of the load is fixed, let's say for example 100 kN, and the direction of the load is also fixed in the horizontal right side direction, then we can say that the load is static. And even after the 1 hour time, the magnitude and direction is unchanged or is fixed, then the load is also known as a static load. The example of this type of a load is dead weight load or a gradually applied load. So what is dead weight load? Whenever you just put a weight, dead weight or a weight or any body having something weight on a particular surface, then the weight applied on that surface is known as a dead weight. And whenever you are applying a particular body on the, whenever you are putting a body on a surface with a minimal amount of height, then this type of the weight applied on the surface due to that kind of application is known as a gradually applied load. So these are the examples of the static load. Now let's go into the different second type, that is the dynamic load. So as we have seen in the static load, the opposite is known as a dynamic load. How we can define the dynamic load? That the magnitude and direction or any one of that criteria might be changing with respect to the time. So we can say that if the magnitude of the load is changing from 100 kN to 50 kN with respect to time over 1 hour, okay, or we can say that if the load is applied in a horizontal right side direction and after 1 hour it is changed to the horizontal left side direction. So the direction is changing or either its magnitude is changing, then that type of a load is known as a dynamic load. So there are different types of example available for the dynamic load, and for that impact load or any fatigue load are the best example for the category under the category of the dynamic load. So what is impact load? So any load which is applied with some height is known as an impact load. So whenever you put the object from the at some particular height and just let it free flow down to the surface, then that object will impact on that surface and it will create some impact on the surface, and that type of a load application is known as an impact loading. Okay, so this comes in under the category of the dynamic load. Okay, so this was all about the different types of the load under the based on the time, that whether the load is changing with respect to time or not. Now let's move on to the next category, that is category based on the application. So loads can be categorized based on the how the load is applied in actually working condition of the object. So we have taken an example of a rectangular block, and as you can see, the rectangular block is having the axis along its length. So the axis of the body is horizontal axis. Now if you consider the cross section area of the rectangle, then you can find it out as a A, B, C, D. You can point out different points A, B, C, D, and that indicates the cross section area of the object. Now there can be possibility that the load can be applied in it from different directions. The load can be applied from horizontal, vertical or inclined directions. So we have considered two different directions, horizontal and vertical. So if you consider the horizontal direction, that line of action or the direction of force will be parallel to the axis of the body, or it will be perpendicular to the cross section area of the body. Okay, so this line of action is perpendicular to the cross section area, and that's why that type of a load is known as normal load. This normal load will create the normal stresses, and that's why this type of a identification of a load is very important. Based on this identification, you will be calculating your examples. Now consider the different direction of application of load. Now if you consider the vertical direction of application, now this type of a load will be applied in a vertical direction. So this direction, as you can see, is perpendicular to the axis of the body and parallel to the cross section area of the object. And that's why this type of a load is known as a tangential load. This load will create a shear stress into your body, and this type of a load is also known as a shear load. So these are the different types of the load which can be categorized based on the application, and any application can be asked in your example, so that you have to identify this type of application for the correct interpretation of your examples. Now let's move on to the third category, that is the category based on the area. Now there are two types of load possible based under this category, that is the point load and distributed load. This both category is relative categories, so you can find it out as per your reference, whether you are considering the reference as a whole surface or a particular small elemental area. So now understand this topic very clearly. Whenever you are taking a surface or any object surface, and the load is applied at a particular point of that surface, load is applied on a particular only one point of that surface, that type of a load is known as a point load. But whenever loads are applied on the entire surface, the entire surface is under the application of the load, then that type of a load application is known as a distributed load condition. So there are different types of a load. First one is a point load, and the second one is a distributed. If you consider the whole surface, let's say for an example, you are taking a beam as an example, beam of any building. So if you are taking a beam of any building as an example, and there is a person standing over the building, there is a person who is standing over the beam. So the weight of the person is applied at a particular point on the entire length of the beam. And that's why that particular load or a weight load of that person is known as a point load. Okay, now next, this is the basic application of the basic example of the point load. Now if you consider a small elemental area of that beam, the area which is sufficient just to stand that person on that beam. Okay, so that much area we have considered on which the person is standing. So for that particular small area, the weight of the person is distributed on the entire area on the particular point. And that's why if this small area is considered as a reference in our example, then the load which is applied on that area will be considered as a distributed load. So these are the loads which you have to consider based on the reference. In your example, if this type of a load is applied, then you will have to consider the if the point load is applied, then you will calculate that example differently, and for the distributed load, your example calculation method will be different. So these are the basic types of the load which you are going to identify for your examples. Further, to calculate the stresses, you will have to identify the moments, couple and torsion effect, because these are the other factors which will create the different types of stresses. So this moment, couple and torsions are nothing but the different cases of these loads or forces. Loads are also known as the forces. So these are the different cases which we are going to explain in the upcoming videos. Okay, so moment is, just to give a brief overview of the moment. Moment is nothing but the turning effect of the forces. So the force into perpendicular distance will give you the answer of the intensity of moment. And if two different forces of same magnitude create the moment turning effect, then it will create the couple. So both of this effect are due to the forces only or due to the loads only, and that's why they will constitute a major part in creating the different types of stresses. So in the upcoming video, we are going to explain that effect. And first we will understand the concept of the moment and couple and torsion. After those understanding those concepts, we will be learning the introduction of the stresses.